Good morning everyone. Now I am going to discuss a problem on binomial distribution. Okay, I am taking one problem and what they are asking in the and how we can find out the given problem solution. The first one is 10 coins are thrown. 10 coins are thrown simultaneously . Find the probability of getting at least first question 7 heads, second one 6 heads, 1 head. Third one is 1 head. 10 coins are thrown simultaneously. Find the probability of getting at least 7 heads. That is nothing but here number of times or number of trials that is equal to small n equal to 10. Okay, here small p is equal to probability of getting head. Probability of getting head. For a coin, two faces are there. One is head and one is tail. The number of total outcomes are 2. Favorable outcome is 1. So, probability of getting head is 1 by 2. Q is equal to probability of not getting head, that is also 1 minus p, it is 1 minus 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 2, taking LCM. Okay. In this, what they are asking, the first question, at least 7 heads. At least 7 heads means minimum 7, maximum 10. That is probability of x is less than, probability of x is greater than or equal to 7. That is nothing but probability of x equal to 7, at least means minimum 7. Either it is 8 or 9 and also 10. In that, minimum is 7. Maximum is 10. So, at least 7 is nothing but this all summation is suitable to this relation of the probability of getting at least 7 heads. So, we can apply in this, that is equal to probability of getting at least 7 means here we are taking small x equal to 7. Probability of capital X is greater than or equal to 7 means either 7 or 8 or 9 or 10. Okay, here we substitute P of 7, that is 10C7 P power, that is nothing but 1 by 2 whole power 7 into 1 by 2 whole power 10 minus 7. Why? Because here n equal to 10, small p is equal to 1 by 2 and small q equal to 1 by 2. And by using of, by the binomial distribution, is given by P of x equal to small r equal to NCR P power r Q power n minus r. By using this relation, we substitute in the place of n 10, in the place of r 7. For this 8, that is 10C8, P is 1 by 2 whole power 8, Q is also 1 by 2 whole power 10 minus 8, plus 10C9, 1 by 2 whole power 9 into 1 by 2 whole power 10 minus 1, plus 10C10, 1 by 2 whole power 10, 1 by 2 whole power 0. 10 minus 10. Okay. It is equal to 10C7 means 10 factorial by 10 minus 7 is 3 factorial into 7 factorial. So 1 by 2 whole power 10 only. It is 3, 10 minus 3. Bases same, powers can be add. 10 minus 7 plus 7 get cancelled. We are getting 10. Plus 10 factorial by 2 factorial into 8 factorial into 1 by 2 whole power 10. Plus 10 factorial by 9 factorial into 1 factorial 1 by 2 whole power 10. 10C10 is 1. 1 into 1 by 2 whole power 10. Okay. That is probability of x is greater than or equal to 7 equal to 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 factorial by 3 into 2 into 7 factorial. 7 factorial, 7 factorial get cancelled. Here whole 1 by 2 is 1 by 2 whole power 10 is right. Outside, it is a common for all terms. Next, plus 10 into 9 into 8 factorial by 2 factorial means 2 only, to 8 factorial. 8 factorial, 8 factorial get cancelled. Plus 10 into 9 factorial by 9 factorial plus 1 by plus 1 whole into 1 by 2 whole power 10. 3 1s are 3 3s are 2 1s are 2 4s are 2 1s are 2 5s are 9 factorial 9 factorial get cancelled is equal to 4 3s are 12 120 plus 9 5s are 45 plus 10 plus 1 into 1 by 2 whole power 10. That is equal to 165, 175, 176. 176 by 2 power 10. We know that 2 power 10 or this is the probability of. Therefore, the probability of at least 7 heads equal to 176 by 2 power 10. Okay. Second one is the probability of getting at least 6 heads. Second one, at least 6 heads, that is nothing but is equal to 6. Here probability of at least 6 means in the same case of at least 7. It is nothing but probability of x equal to 6 plus probability of x is greater than or equal to 7. Why? Because at least 6 means 6 7, 8, 9, 10. 7 to 10 already came in the first case. Okay, we take here probability of x equal to 6 added to the first case of the given problem, then we are getting the at least 6 heads. It is equal to n is 10 c 6 into 1 by 2 whole power 6 into 1 by 2 whole power 10 minus 6 plus 176 by 2 power 10. 10 c 6 means 10 factorial by 6 factorial, 10 minus 6, 4 factorial, 1 by 2 whole power 10 plus 176 by 2 power 10. Here taking 2 power 10 is LCM. Here 10 factorial equal to the probability of x is greater than or equal to 6 equal to 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 factorial by 6 factorial into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 plus into 1 by 2 whole power 10 plus 176 by 2 power 10. 6 factorial cancel. 4 1s are 4 2s are 2 1s are 2 1s are 7 1s are 3 1s are 3 3s are. It is equal to 7 3s are 21. 2 10 by 2 power 10 plus 176 by 2 power 10. It is nothing but 386 by 2 power 10. It is the at least 6 heads. Next, third case. At least one head. At least one head. That is nothing but probability of x is greater than or equal to 1 equal to how much? Here we are taking 1 minus probability of x equal to x is less than or equal to 1. Here simply we can take one minus probability of x equal to 0. Okay. Why? Because 1, 2, 3 up to 10. But the summation starts from 0. We know that the probability of all terms equal to 1. That is nothing but the probability summation is equal to 1. If the outcomes or events are n events are there, union of n events probability must be 1. That is equal to sample space probability. That is nothing but 1 minus probability of x equal to 0. Then we are getting the at least one head. It is equal to 1 minus 10 c naught 1 by 2 whole power 0 into 1 by 2 whole power 10. It is equal to 1 minus 1 into 1 by 2 power 10. It is 1 minus 1 by 2 power 10 is the probability of at least one head. It is the solution of the given three cases. In this, we are using the binomial distribution. Thank you.